Now, the second part is actually, in many cases, a totally different group. Again, within a JIC. So if you imagine you're in a Joint Information Center, you've got lots of different communicators. We have one group of people, your job, go find out what's happening and validate that. Another group is now going to actually be, if you will, our writers, if you will. So develop and coordinate the information. Now, they have two very important jobs. The first one is establishing key messaging. And these are really, think of these as your main talking points. And what they are the key things that you will be sending out to a large number of folks within your organization, more than likely, so they can develop their own messaging. But it's based on your key talking points. The mission of having quickly developed talking points, validated with the information that's been gathered, is that what we're trying to do is get in front of the information. The mission of having the right talking points is to get the right information, what we're saying about our situation, to the right people at the right time. And so they can make the right decisions. Now, this is an important issue, and you can design an exercise solely around this. And I'll talk more about exercises at the end, but I want to give a shout out for this. What I find in many organizations that we work with is that this skill of developing talking points, having them quickly approved, is a very slow process, either because they're not focused on it initially or they get bogged down. You should clearly have identified key messaging already in your templates, and you take it out at time of disaster, you modify and change it, you quickly go through the approval process, which we'll talk about when I talk about governance, and what you'll do then is be able to then disseminate those key talking points to a large number of people who need them in order to communicate with employees and customers and other entities. The slower you are in doing that, people will just make it up. And that's a problem. So what is your key messaging? The number one activity of this group under develop and coordinate. The second thing is getting the appropriate approval. And I'll talk a lot about that when I talk about governance, but what you need to do is certainly if you've activated your crisis management team, if you're utilizing the incident command system, you'll notice in my slide I utilize the term incident commander, the IC. You want to make sure that all key messaging has been seen and approved by your incident commander or whatever you call the name of the person who's in charge of your crisis management team, incident management team. And what we're looking for in this process is streamlined approval, which I'll talk a lot about when I get to governance. But we want to make sure that the key messaging has been delivered. And by the way, it should not be on a white piece of paper. You should already have key messages that you're just going to modify it on the fly. Then you're going to get them approved through that quick process that you have. And ideally, every one of these messages should be seen by the incident commander. So step two, critically important, develop and coordinate that information. But we can't do that before we've done step one.